FactsVerse presents. Son sees parents' wedding video, but one unusual detail catches his eye. Joe and Beverly were high school sweethearts. She was a cheerleader. He was a football player. They traveled in the same social circle, and they fell in love. Many relationships that start in high school don't last through college. Joe and Beverly, however, were different. They were in love, and shortly after graduating high school, Joe popped the question. They were just 19 years old when they got married in 1953. There was a photographer at the wedding who was capturing the video of the couple's big day, and there was one shot that they liked the best. It was of the happy couple in front of their car. But when the couple got married in upstate New York, there was a war going on across the world, and it would soon change Joe and Beverly's lives. When Joe found out that he was being drafted, he didn't know what to do. He and Beverly were still newlyweds, and the idea of leaving his bride was heartbreaking. To make sure that Beverly had enough money to support herself while he was gone, Joe had to sell many of his prized possessions, and that included the couple's beloved car. Beverly and Joe wanted to keep in touch as much as possible, so they sent letters and photos daily in hopes of keeping their love alive. It was something that many married couples did when they were torn apart because of the war. Beverly worried daily that her husband may never come home. But finally, it was time for Joe to head home to his bride. His military duty had been fulfilled, and finally he could start his life with Beverly. They started a family, and growing up, Joe would often tell his child war stories from the time that he spent in Korea. They were your typical American family, and Joe says that his life was everything he had hoped it would be. Beverly and Joe had a wonderful marriage, and when they made it to their 60th wedding anniversary, they decided to have a big party. The celebration was great, too, and Joe says there were some great food, great friends, family, and lots of reminiscing. The couple was shocked when a friend pulled out a video of the wedding. Joe and Beverly were thrilled that they were going to be able to relive their wedding day on their 60th anniversary. They were watching the video when everybody noticed the look on Joe's face when he saw his car. It was a 1948 red Plymouth convertible. Joe says it seemed like he was watching a long-lost family member on the video. He started to tell his family about the car and what it actually meant to him way back when. He admitted selling the car before he went to Korea, it broke his heart, but he had to do what was necessary to make sure that his wife was going to be all right until he came back from Korea. The couple's son Joel says that his earliest memories weren't his own. They came from stories that their parents told them. He says the car was part of many of the couple's stories, and he knew how much his father loved that car and he wished he'd still had it. And that was when he got an idea. He was going to try his best to give his parents the best gift ever. Joel searched online for weeks trying to find a car that was exactly like his father's old car. He managed to find one, but it was on display in a museum. Two others had already been bought. Well, finally, he found a car just like his father's on Craigslist. The description matched what Joel was looking for, but unfortunately there were no photos of the car. He didn't know if it was a scam, if the car was legit. To Joel, it almost seemed too good to be true. The ad stated that the owner had never taken the car out during winter, so it was in great shape. They also told him the car also had relatively low mileage. The only problem was that there were no pictures of the car. So Joel decided to send a friend to Indiana to check out the car for him. Joel's friend went to look at the car and contacted Joel. He told him that the seller was an 81-year-old man who didn't know much about technology. That was why he didn't have any photos posted of the car on the ad. The car came with all the maintenance records, and it even had the original owner's manual. Joel purchased the car and got it back to upstate New York. When Joel gave his dad Joe the car, Joe's eyes filled with tears. He couldn't believe that his son would give him such an expensive and meaningful gift. He says as soon as he got into that car, all of the memories started coming flooding back. He says for him, the gift brought pure joy. He says that he's going to keep that car and make sure that it gets passed down from generation to generation. So it sounds like Joel might actually get that car back someday. Do you have a car that you absolutely loved when growing up? What was it? Tell us in the comments below and subscribe for more.